right, welcome to Love Audio's YouTube channel. If you're new here, you don't know me. My name is Paul Weber, and I'm here to help you with the basics in audio production. Now, in today's video, I want to demonstrate two ways in which you can get Waves Ovox to act as a voice changer for your audio productions. And we're starting right now. Love Audio. All right, don't forget to say hi in the chat. We are more than welcome to kind of shout you out. If you're listening to us or watching us from around the world, do let us know where you are from and what kind of time of day it is. It's actually just gone 8 o'clock here in the UK, British summertime, and it is very, very hot. We're getting a heat wave again in the next few days. In fact, there's a weather warning out tomorrow, I think, right the way through till Saturday for hot weather. So we are looking forward to it. We're looking forward to it, but we're not looking forward to it because we desperately need rain here in this country. I can tell you, right now, inside this garage studio, it is, and it was 27 earlier, it's getting hotter because the equipment and stuff that's on here, but it's now 28 degrees Celsius, whatever that is in Fahrenheit. I'm sure you can do your own workings out, but yeah, it's extremely hot in here. So that's why I've got myself some cool drink. So yeah, some ice in it as well, as you can probably tell, which is cool. All right, so we're going to get straight into it. I'm going to dive into vMix, and I'm going to be showing you the audio settings that's coming from the Rodecaster Pro. So give me 2 seconds while I open up that particular window. So if we do that, you should be able to see, if I bring up these windows here, these are the audio settings now for the Rodecaster. So what you're seeing here on screen is the Rodecaster Pro audio settings coming in. And then what you'll see is two instances of Ovox Stereo. Now, that's the Waves plugin that changes your voice. It's like a vocoder, if you will. So that's what's showing in the plugins. What you do to add a new plugin is very simply go into the settings here, the general settings on vMix, find the general settings, go down to plugins, and then you click the plus button. That will bring up a selection of drivers. And you have different VST, NDI plugins here, inputs and outputs. My particular one is the Wave Shell 1 VST3 12.7x64. So I click that, and then it will bring in the plugin concerned. So you bring in the driver first, and then it'll open up a dialog window that says plugin, and you click OK, and that brings it into that section there. So if you're wondering how to get a plugin into vMix, use vMix yourself for production purposes, you know, for video production, that kind of thing, video recording, whatever, then that's how you do that. So you get a plugin first of all. So this is the first way that we're going to demonstrate that kind of voice changing aspect. And it's interesting because don't forget, I'm using the Rodecaster Pro 1, not the Rodecaster Pro 2, which does have its own built-in voice-changing software. And it's on one of the hardware buttons. You can press that and it changes a voice, that kind of thing. So, you know, it's interesting from this point of view. So we're trying to set it up, but without using the Rodecaster Pro 2 because we don't have one yet. So that's why we're doing it like this. The second way that I'm going to be bringing this in for you is to show you it in the Presonus Studio One 5.5 Pro software as well. So we can drag it into there and then have that open at the same time as you are, you know, kind of broadcasting, if you will, and then have that as your voice changing option, potentially anyway. That's how we're going to try and do it. Whether it works or not is entirely up to the system and my abilities to help you show you around there, right? So first of all, what I'm going to do is go to this top one. So this is Ovox Stereo. Two instances of that, of course, as I say. I've got two different settings on there as well. And we're going to tick the box that's at the top there where that blue is highlighted, okay? And you should, with any luck, hear
a change in my voice now. Because I can hear my own voice in my headphones, I don't know whether you're hearing the synthesized voice coming back to you, or whether you're also hearing my voice come back to you as at the same time. Now, if I listen to the output of the computer, what I'm getting is a synthesized version of my voice and not the original voice. So hopefully that's what you're getting on the stream. Do let me know in the comments, won't you? Because this is obviously an experiment. I want to make sure we get it right. So are you hearing an electronic deep voice coming through, or are you hearing a deep voice alongside my voice at the same time. Please do let me know in the comments, and that would be really, really useful if you can do that. And talking to comments, what I need to do is just configure something very quickly. Give me 2 seconds while I do that. Let's reduce that one for you. This is the Ovox software, by the way. I'll leave it on screen whilst we sort out vMix Social. So we're going to get that on screen right now. We're going to do that. And that will probably bring up my, that thought. So let's log out from that. Because we need to log into to my other one for a second. Hang on a sec. Yeah, let's go to, I think it's probably that one that we need. So, okay, that's fine. Allow. Shut that down. That's cool. Bring that in there like that. Yeah, okay, so that's good. It's recognized that I had a change of voice. Click on that. And we click on that as well. And that hopefully should bring comments up on the screen. Alright, so we're going to go back to the Ovox settings there. We just have those on screen. So that's the Ovox that's operating right now. And I just realised that I've been talking to you and it's probably still got the deep voice on it. Please do let me know in the comments whether this is working or not, because that would be really, really useful. Is it working or not? Are we getting what we should be getting, which of course is the deep voice? Or are you getting my voice alongside that? In fact, let me
turn that off for 2 seconds.
The bring in one, which is kind of a higher voice, and I've just changed a different setting on that. So, is that bringing in a higher voice than my normal voice, or is it bringing in my voice alongside the synthesized voice? Do let me know again in the comments, if you will.
And I'll take that off, and it should be hopefully back to normal now. So it would be really good if you can let me know. that this is working, because obviously I can't monitor the stream itself, not without getting feedback and all that kind of stuff. So I wanted to make sure that we can test it on screen, and then you guys can hear it and let me know if it's working or not. This is a good way of bringing in a voice changer if you don't have the Rodecaster Pro 2, or you don't have a synthesizer that you can plug into to kind of change your voice, etc. This is Waves Ovox that we're using currently, and I'll bring up that that thing again. Whoops, there we go. So there we go, that's the software there, which is pretty cool. And it allows you to change all sorts of stuff. So we've got random E giant here on the setting itself for this particular setting. And then on the other one, I've got a guy, it's called Low Guy. But what I've done is I've tuned it up, so that's actually a higher version instead of the low version. So, that's what we've done on there. And you know, to switch between the two, what you need to do in vMix, of course, is have this open, which is the audio settings for the Rodecaster Pro. And then what you do is you
just highlight the one that you want to bring in, which, of course, that one's the deep one.
And then that one is the high one. So the high one.
Low one, like that.
High one, like that.
I mean, you could be
really ridiculous. Take that off. That should now be back to deep voice, as opposed to high voice. Do let me know again in the comments, if you will. And that will enable me to test this and to see if it's actually working or not. Okay. There we go. So, that will be one way of bringing in a voice changer that you could use, and it's just using the plugins inside vMix. So I'm going to close that
out now, and close that down, and close that, and close that as well. And so we're back to square one, which is fantastic. Let's go here. Reduce that. But now what I'm going to do is bring in an instance of Studio One 5.5 Pro. Now that's obviously the editing software that I use, and the DAW, the digital audio workstation. Okay. So what we do now is we bring that in as a source, as an audio source, once it's loaded up, and we'll do a brand new mix, just new song. We're going to call this, let's look at voice changer, today's date 08/08/22, and that's absolutely fine. That's all fine. Click on OK, and we're going to bring in a track which we don't have yet. So bring in a stereo track. In fact, no, we're not going to bring in that. We're going to bring in an instrument track. In fact, And then we'll try this one and we'll go here. And what we do is we go up to the instruments and we go to, let's have a look here. Vendor, let's have a look at vendor, yeah. Okay. Favorites, let's undo that. It's not there currently. Give me 2 seconds. Instruments, here we go. So flat, folder, synth, my time, mojito, note, sampler, note. Okay, notes, no, that's not it. External instruments, right, here we go. External instruments, nothing on there. Multi-instruments, interesting, okay. External instruments, nothing on there either. Why is that? interesting. It should be there by vendor. You got Presonus there, but it doesn't have the Ovox, which is interesting. Why doesn't it have the Waves Ovox in there? That's really, really interesting. Okay, so maybe we can't bring it in there for some reason. I don't know why. Which is pretty awkward because I was hoping to try that, you know, on the stream and stuff like that. So, yeah. Where can I find that? Why is it not showing up? That's more of a worry for me that it's not actually showing up in the where it normally is. Multi-instrument, no. External, it's not there. Favorites, it's not there either. Recent, no, nothing there at all. Interesting. I'll do a search for, let's go waves. No, rough waves. No, that's not going to find it. Let's try Ovox, O-V-O-X. Ovox is not there either. Very interesting. Okay. Well, that's really worrying. yeah, that's kind of worrying, to be fair. Instruments, effects. Effects. I guess it's an effect, yeah. So let's try that. Let's go straight down to the bottom. There's a ton of stuff in here, which is amazing. Tone generator. Ah, here we go. Right down the bottom. Under effects, not under instruments, because it's not an instrument, you fool. It's an effect. That's why I couldn't find it. So I double-click on that. Come on. There we go. Waves. Open up waves. Where are you? Doesn't want to play games with me. It's not working properly. Why is that? interesting. Okay. Where are we? Presonus. Don't need that. Here we go. Okay. Ovox Stereo. Found it. Okay. Brilliant. So we're going to bring Ovox Stereo into the vocal track like that. Okay, let's click on that and take that off there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, if I do that, nothing coming through currently because it's on full reset. But if we change that to vocoding and we go to, let's say, for instance, Fat Boy, which is that, you should, hopefully, fingers crossed and the wind in the right direction. Now, wow, okay. It does help if you put the fader up on the, yeah, that's really fat. Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2. Wow. Now, again, if you can let me know whether my voice is coming alongside the Fat Boy thing, or whether you can just hear the effect from Fat Boy coming through, you know, do you know what I mean? So on its own or with me in the background as well. That would be really useful. Thank you. 1, 2. Wow. I think it's coming through on its own, because when I press the ear button on the Rodecaster Pro, what I hear is a really loud, gruff, giant effect. So yeah, do let me know, won't you? Which is very interesting. Wow, okay, that's pretty cool. And what it means is you can bring that in and, you know, use it as a voice changer. And all you do to turn it off should be that. So you just turn off the listening feature on the And I realise you can't see that because it's off screen. Let me just try that. And you'll see the full... Whit says he hears both. Brilliant. So you should now just be able to hear my voice, Whit, if that's correct. Hopefully it is, which is pretty cool. So yeah, just to hear it on its own, you bring in, you switch on this button here, which is the listen button, just there. So now you should be able to hear the fat boy thing, and I don't know if you hear my voice alongside it. Is it just growling or is it both, or it's a very strange effect. Let's try something different. Okay, so voice effects, pitch up, fast rate. Okay, so that's different. So now you've got this kind of weird going on with regards to the synth sound. Now, are you just hearing that? That's really weird. That's really bizarre. Or are you hearing my voice, my normal voice alongside it? That's the question. That would be really useful to know. Which says he hears both. Correct. Brilliant. Okay. That's odd. That's a very strange effect. Isn't it? Let's try something different. Hang on. Hearing both. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Human after all. I don't know what that setting is. But anyway, it sounds a bit electronic, a bit kind of weird. Yeah, that's not working either. So let's try something different. Electronic B-Vox. Electronic B-Vox. No idea. But it seems to be singing to me for some reason. Strange. So I guess it depends on the routing and stuff like that, whether you have your voice coming into this or whether you just have the audio coming back to you. Maybe if we do that, no, that's no difference. Wow. Okay. Interesting. Dream coder. Okay. So that's a dream coder, apparently, which is changing pitch and changing melody as I speak into it, which is kind of bizarre. Oh. Wow. Okay. 2, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello. Hello. No, doesn't do anything. There, we're back to Fat Boy again. But we can change the pitch. It's really grumbling, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. Ooh, okay. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2. Interesting. Voice. Sidechain. No. Track. Sidechain. Never know. No idea what that means. Well, I don't know what it means, but it's just not working. So it's track that it's coming in on. Okay. Synth. 1, 2. Wow. Now that's weird. Wow, okay. Very interesting sounds coming out of this thing. Although that's not bad. But we have, yeah, we've increased it, haven't we? So, ooh, that's the deep one again. Okay. 1, 2. 1, 2. Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, yeah. Voice effects. beneath my kilt. I have no clue what that means. Well, it's obviously something to do with Scottish, but I don't know if it's, you know, relative. Whoa, what's this? Some kind of synth. And every time I talk, it's triggering the synth. Interesting. No idea what that does. Downer. Okay. There we go. So you got the electronic voice back again. But again, I don't know if it's working or not, or whether it's coming through with my voice alongside it or not. Do let me know. Very, very strange sounds. Can you hear that? That's bizarre. Yeah, strange effects going on with this particular effect. Hang on. Octave down. Okay. That's supposedly my voice, but an octave lower than it normally would be. Which is interesting. One, two. Okay. Very bizarre. And again, there's tons of things on here. Just, you know, you need all night to go through all of the presets on here. But you can certainly bring up different effects and things like that, which is good. So that's one way of bringing it in as well, coming through the Studio One. So you've got the voice changer there as well. But if it's bringing in my voice alongside that, then obviously it's not working as well. That one is working, says Whit. Excellent. Okay. Probably because it's very similar to the human voice, but it's, it's coming through with my voice alongside it, and that's really distracting, so I have to take my earphone off because it's making me slur my words. Okay, that's bizarre. All right. Rich says, good evening. Hello, Rich. Nice to see you. Just messing around here, trying to get voice changes on. We've done the Studio One thing through Studio One 5.5 Pro. Now back to normal, thank goodness. Let's get back to a normal screen as well. And, we've also demonstrated how to get it in as a plugin in vMix itself. So you can do that as we demonstrated a little earlier on. So if I do that again for you, so bringing in the Rodecaster Pro audio settings here, which you should be able to see on screen right now. In fact, if I do that, then I can bring myself down at the bottom end of the corner here as well, so that's cool. So what you've got here is the settings itself. You go down to plugins, and then we've got Ovox 1 and Ovox 2, two instances of that. So if I click on
Ovox 1, you should now be able to hear my voice coming through to you as a deep voice through the software, through vMix, but not with my voice alongside it, okay? Which is quite good.
So untick that, back to normal.
And if I click that one, that should be bringing a higher voice, much higher voice than my own. I'm talking normally into the microphone. What you should be hearing is a higher-pitched version of my voice coming back to you. Now, if that's the case, you thumbs up, let me know that that is right, because that tends to work better than we just did with the Studio One 5.5 Pro on Presonus, bringing me in as a voice changer. So,
let's do that.
We'll bring that deep one back in like that. And, that should be bringing in a deep voice now. Which is much deeper than my normal voice. They both worked. Brilliant. Okay, good. Okay, that's interesting. Good, because sometimes, obviously, the voice comes through. You know, you get my normal voice through at the same time, and that's what I was trying to avoid by doing that. So, hopefully, fingers crossed that both versions worked well. That is how you bring that in, pointing at the screen like you can see it, obviously, but you can. So that's how you bring it in a plug-in version. And again, just swap them.
Those two there. So untick the Ovox Stereo 1 on the top, and then
you tick the bottom one, and that comes in as a higher voice. That's the one you just heard, obviously. That's two different settings of Ovox coming in, and I can show you that on the editor here. So these will turn up to be quite high tune. I can bring that down a bit so it's not quite so high. And this one can bring that down as well. And then going up slightly on that. Let's bring that down. Bring that down. Bring that down. Bring that down. So again, you can adjust that on the fly if you need to give you that that weird kind of that electronic voice, which is going to be deeper or higher than the one you normally use. And that's the idea. That's how we're kind of playing around with all these settings here on Ovox. Ovox you can get from Waves, by the way, WAVES Waves. They do a ton of plugins for audio production, and hashtag not sponsored, by the way. So yeah, get yourself along to Waves, sign up for their program, and then you can download as many as you need, I believe, as part of their program, which is cool. And yeah, this particular one is called Ovox, O-V-O-X, Ovox. So there you go.
That's the deep one again, that's this one here. And again, if I do that and show the editor for that one, it's a slightly different setting. So we've got the tune quite down, and the format is quite down as well. So this is quite hard, it's more people to hear what I'm saying, the T's and the S's. So I've got the sibilance up quite high. Voice, I can change that, which is bringing in something else perhaps. And you can bring in, so get more of the background stuff going on, which I don't really need. That's how the Ovox working, just down there. You can change the tone of the output, so it can be quite muffled, quite muddy. Or you can bring that up and give it a bit more sparkle like that. And this is the output here, which is fine. And if you, there's a limiter on there as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, so you've got a limiter on there as well. So if you didn't want it to peak, you put a limiter on. It stops it going any further, so you don't peak at your end, which is cool. Okay. And there are all sorts of other different effects you can dial into this. Internal synth, there's an arpeggiator. If you wanted to get into the note making side of things as well with this, which is cool. Ah, there we go. So this different view here that shows what's going on down the bottom. So the modulator down the bottom here is going nuts. As you can see, it's quite random, the phase is quite random on that. You can slow the rate down of that, of course, or you can speed the rate up so it goes faster. You can warp it so it's not the same thing every time you speak. And the level of it you can bring up as well, so the level can be really high. And there's a sequence there as well, that shows a different sequence, and you can change these as well. You can erase stuff, you can write your own in here. So for instance, if we erased all of that and draw our own in, like that. Okay, that now takes on a completely different note formation, if you like, on the software, which is pretty cool. We're going to go for smooth, so we're smoothing out a bit, just not quite so jumpy. Bring the rate down to 1/8 of a note. Yeah, that's pretty good, I like that. And so you can adjust that on the fly, as I say, and yeah, it's pretty good. Okay. Alright, so that's a good demonstration of the Ovox software. This particular session is called Random E-Giant. it's kind of a play on words with Richard E. Grant, I guess. But anyway, Random E-Giant is what you get with that one. And then we can untick that.
And then bring in probably that one, perhaps, and show the editor there, which is here. And again, that's a different thing going on. You've got effects and distortion and stuff here. Distortion, you've got the settings loony. You can have clipped, freaky, squashed, frenzy, dizzy, trippy, buzzed, all that kind of stuff. Which is pretty cool. And it depends if you want more distortion or less distortion. The mix could be 50%, so right in the middle there. Or you drop it down to about 20% or 20%, whichever you want to do. And there's drive on there and colour and all sorts of stuff as well. Different effects you've got as well, the plugin list is here. So you've got auto pan, you've got chorus, compressor, delay, limiter and reverb on there as well. So you can change all that kind of stuff. Let's try chorus, for instance. So it's now got a chorus on it. And you change the rate, you've got a mix here as well, you've got a depth that it's doing some kind of chorus to, which is cool. This is a ton of stuff you can use on it, which is cool. That's the simplified version there. You just click on that box and that opens up a whole new load of dialogue. Like that. Okay?
It is really, really in-depth, and I suggest if you do go and buy it,
Sorry, let me take that off because that's really frustrating for you guys, isn't it? If you do go and buy it, then experiment with it and try different settings on it for yourself, perhaps, and you'll get an idea of how to use it. And if you use it in your own productions, then do let me know how you get on with it. So that's tonight's subject. Yeah, voice changer. So we've used a voice changer with Ovox, Waves Ovox, and we've used it. I feel like I've turned up on the set of Star Wars. funny you should say that. Hang on. Funny you should say that. And of course, if I had the Rodecaster Pro 2, I'd be able to switch very easily to the different settings. But I do have... Hang on. That's not it. I do have this. Come on, play for me, please. Hang on. Where are we? Bank 2, correct. And why is that not playing? Interesting. Okay. I don't know what. Transfer a sound to computer? No. Transfer a sound to your Rodecaster Pro? Yes. Oh, no, don't worry about that. No. No. That's good. Sorry, you can't even see that, can you? I beg your pardon. What I was doing was this on the Rodecaster Pro. If we move that over, you can see this. This is a sound that I've got lined up, but I want to be able to play it. Play. There we go. Okay, brilliant. So playback style play. Excellent. So if I press play, that's not that. Why is it not showing on my buttons? That's what I want to know. Podcast, no. Sounds, yes. 80% of available memory free, correct. But why can't I play it? This is interesting. Okay. Very interesting. Play, trash talk, no idea. Pause, replay, play. Yeah, it's not showing the buttons. Oh, maybe I've got to go into my settings. Hang on a second. Let's go to the Rodecaster Pro settings. Hang on. Sounds. Here we go. Right. Okay. Now I've got it. So we have got Star Wars. And we're not playing any more of that because I'll get copyright strikes. You know what it's like. yeah. So... So we do have that on file, in case you were wondering, Rich. Thanks very much for the thing. But what you've got to do is, it's okay with this, and it shows the buttons there and everything else, right? But if you want to change the pads on the Rodecaster Pro itself, you have to go into the settings and then bring up the correct... the correct settings on that. Disco Star Wars. Yeah, that's Miko in Star Wars. Yeah, all fun and games. Anyway, if you want to help me, by the way, you can support the channel, patreon.com/loveaudioproductions, where you can find that. If you want to go to the Love Audio website, that, of course, is loveaudio.co.uk. And merchandise you can find at loveaudiosmerchstore.com. If you're after... let's say cables, microphones, mic stands, that kind of stuff, get yourself over to loveaudiobits.co.uk. Free delivery for all orders over £20. And still plenty of stuff in stock. So get yours while they are hot. And if you haven't yet subscribed, then make sure you subscribe. Click the bell icon as well. That'll let you know when I go live next, which is generally Monday nights at 8 p.m. GMT, British summertime, whichever way around it is. We'd love to see you on a future show. But that is it for tonight's demonstration of the voice changer. Thanks so much for hanging out, and I'll catch you on the next one.